The sun contains 99.8% of the entire mass of the solar system. So it looks like to us, everything seems to be orbiting the sun. So why doesn't the sun capture the moon from the Earth, like a schoolyard bully snatching the Earth's lunch money? Well, that would all make sense, right? It all fits with our skewed view of social hierarchy based on an entity's volume. Well, good news, it's already happened, in a way. The sun has already captured the moon. So if you look at the orbit of the moon, it orbits the sun, similar to the way the Earth does. Normally, the motion of the moon around the sun is drawn as a kind of spirograph pattern. But its actual motion is basically the same orbit as Earth, but with a small wobble to it. So the moon also orbits the Earth. Now you might think this is because the Earth is much closer to the moon than the sun. After all, the strength of gravity depends not only on the mass of an object, but also on its distance from you. But this isn't the case. The sun is about 400 times more distant from the moon than the Earth, but the sun is also about 330,000 times more massive. So if you're up for some napkin calculations, you little mathlete, by using Newton's law of gravity, you find that even with its greater distance, the sun pulls on the moon about twice as hard as the Earth does. So why can't the moon escape the Earth? In order to escape the gravitational pull of a body, you need to be moving fast enough relative to that body to escape its pull. And this is known as the escape velocity of the object. So yes, the sun is totally trying to rip the moon away from the Earth, but the Earth is super clingy. The speed of the moon around the Earth is about 1 kilometer per second. At the moon's distance from the Earth, the escape velocity is about 1.2 kilometers per second. So the moon simply isn't moving fast enough to escape the Earth. But man, those numbers sure are close. I wonder if we could kickstart a rocket and just stick it on the side. So even though the moon can't escape the Earth, it's gradually moving away. And this is due to the tidal interactions between the Earth and Moon, which we talk about in another video, and we'll link that at the end of this one. So even though the Moon will never escape the Earth, it will continue to move away. So what do you think? What kind of devious project should we start to get the Moon that little boost so it finally escapes the clingy Earth and all its clingy Klingon clinginess? Tell us in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Never miss an episode by clicking subscribe. Our Patreon community is the reason these shows happen, and we'd like to thank Jeffrey Binks and James Oliver, and the rest of the members who support us creating great space and astronomy content for the world to view for free. And if you want to get in on the action and join our community, click here. You've got advanced access to episodes, video extras, and behind the scenes goofballery and participation in contests and other shenanigans with Jay, myself, and the rest of the team. So click right here and head on over to Patreon.
Into the woods. Go, Fraser. Be free.